messages of poetry, but none of us would ever listen. But she would let us stay up late if we would hear them, her little stories in the kitchen. And by far the best she ever read was one written by Tennyson. We listened hard to every word she said. It was the legend of Enoch Arden. They were three best friends since they were only children, Enoch and Philip and the beautiful Annie. When the two young boys grew up to be strong men, they both loved her, but Annie loved one of them. He wasn't gonna try to tear them apart, so Philip still came to wish them well. But he was crying from a broken heart when Annie wed Enoch Arden. He said, I've loved you both since we were only children, and Annie, I know you've chosen well. There is no other man who is walking this earth, no truer heart than Enoch Arden. Now Enoch worked on the open sea, trying to provide for his family. And one day Annie begged him not to leave, when they sent him on down to the Caribbean. She said, please don't go, you'll be gone so long, I don't really know if I can be that strong. He said, Annie, my girl, don't you be sad, by the next full moon I'll be back to you. 10 years went by and he still never came. Maybe that ship went down in a winter rain. Philip came to ease her pain. He said, Annie, we will never be whole again, but we will always remember him, our oldest friend. Together Annie and Philip grew old, but there was something they'd never know. That Enoch found land just west of the meridian, and he waited to be rescued home. They found him there as a very old man, brought him back to his homeland. But when he heard Annie married again, she was blessed by Enoch Arden, 'cause he had loved them both since they were only children, and he knew that Annie had chosen well. And he pledged that he'd never try to tear them apart, but it pierced through the heart of Enoch Arden. My mother used to read us passages of poetry, and there was one by Tennyson. She would let us stay up late if we would listen to the legend of Enoch Arden. It was the legend of Enoch Arden.